Organs are for sale in China. At least 36 death camps in China are harvesting organs from Falun Gong practitioners for sale on the black market, many of them while they are still alive. Organ harvesting of Falun Gong practitioners was confirmed by a two-month investigation by former Canadian Secretary of State David Kilgour and the Canadian international human rights lawyer David Matas.
You've been asked to investigate allegations. After considering everything as best we could, was that the allegations are true. We believe them to be true, that this harvesting is indeed happening. To us, this is a form of evil we have yet to see in this planet.
Harvesting organs from prisoners is nothing new in China, but since the persecution of Falun Gong began in 1999, there has been a steady rise in the number of organs available for transplant. That's why Dr. Wenyi Wang challenged Chinese President Hu Jintao on the White House lawn.
I had encountered some Chinese patients who had gone to China and came back with kidneys. And when I asked them where they came from, they said, oh, it was my cousin or something like that. But then some of them told me that they had bought the kidneys from executed prisoners. Although the government said that this was something they had gotten consent for, that the prisoners had agreed to beforehand or the families had consented, the evidence was overwhelming that there wasn't any consent involved. And in fact, it was just the government doing what they wanted.
The South China Post reported that 99% of organ transplants in China come from executed prisoners. The Chinese government has been harvesting organs from prisoners since the 80s. The U.S. State Department has known about this, and it has been addressed at several hearings. Since 1999, many of these organs have come from illegally detained Falun Gong practitioners.
Right from the beginning, just months after the persecution first started in China, we got reports of tens of thousands, perhaps hundreds of thousands, of individuals being detained, put into prison camps, labor camps. This developed an increase over the years. And what we had was, particularly in the period between 2000 and 2003, hundreds and hundreds of thousands, if not millions, of Falun Gong practitioners in labor camps throughout China. Many of those were taken from their homes by police, no paperwork, no judicial process, and thrown into prisons, and many of their family members had no idea where they were.
The Canadian report finds executed prisoners cannot account for the rise in organ transplants starting in 1999. There were just as many executions before and after Falun Gong began to be persecuted, but the number of transplants increased by 41,500.
And then we come up with this figure of the source of 41,500 transplants for a six-year period from 2000 to 2005 is unexplained.
Two witnesses from mainland China were the first people to go public with information about organs being removed from live Falun Gong practitioners at Su Jiatun Medical Facility in Shenyang City. Only Falun Gong practitioners were detained at Su Jiatun. There were about 6,000. Since then, a Chinese military doctor has said that there are at least 36 camps like Su Jiatun throughout China. Most Falun Gong practitioners are held in the northern regions of Heilongjiang, Jilin, and Liaoning. Subsequent investigations by the World Organization to Investigate the Persecution of Falun Gong have confirmed these findings. Throughout China, hospitals advertise their transplant services. As you can see, this is a big business. But many hospitals in China claim organs can be delivered quickly. This organization claims it can get a kidney for transplant in as little as 1 week.
If you could, you know the blood types of everyone you had in prison, and if you could execute people to order, then you could certainly deliver hearts and livers. And anything else you wanted to do on a short time frame. The current wait In New Jersey, for kidneys, is 4 to 5 years. In New York City, it's 8 to 10 years.
And the Communist Party has its own organ bank. Hundreds of thousands of imprisoned, often undocumented Falun Gong practitioners.
There's no other way of guaranteeing the opportunity of having an organ available on a scheduled basis other than to say we'll have to schedule an execution.
This Falun Gong practitioner said she witnessed many practitioners being tested.
In 2001, I was illegally held at Daxing County Labor Camp in Beijing. All Falun Gong practitioners held there were taken out and underwent physical exams. We had our blood drawn and x-rays taken. We also had urine tests and eye exams.
One imprisoned Falun Gong practitioner was told her organs were not good enough for transplant.
First, they had my kidney examined, then my blood, my skin, my liver, and then my eyes. After the exam, they determined that I was sick and took me back to the concentration camp.
It is unknown how many Falun Gong practitioners did suffer from the fate Yuji Wang narrowly escaped. Falun Gong practitioners worldwide are calling upon all people of conscience to investigate further and help put an end to organ harvesting in China.